You're right there, guys. What's going on? Welcome back to the Ultimate RTG. And I'm going to say this once. If you haven't seen the Weekend League Rewards part of this Road to Glory series, make sure you pause this video. What I will do, in fact, is paste the link right at the top of the comment section. I'll pin it myself. So all that you got to do, pause this video, go and click that, go halfway through the video, and that's where you will see the Weekend League Rewards part of this series. Something happened. Something big happened. Check it out if you haven't caught up with them, and we are ready for another episode of the RTG. Okay, a lot of things have been going down. So many changes, new players being brought in, those players being sold. I just haven't really found a team that is ready for the Weekend League right now. I've had an issue with chemistry in the defense, goalkeeper problems. It's been a little hectic over the past couple of days. Foot Division Rivals has felt really weird, like 3 or 4 days, and the Weekend League is upon us. It got pushed back even. So we've had just that extra day to get things ready and start practicing, and I'm not playing too bad. It's just that the team right now, I'm needing more coins to finish it off, and I don't really want to sell my Arsenal investments. So I've done the best that I can. I've brought in new players, and I want to show you this team. But I would just warn you, chemistry is a bit of a problem right now, so don't judge me. But let's take a look at some of the players that we have packed. Lala, we sold on. That was a couple of days ago. We picked him up for around 31,000, sold him on for 33. Awesome right back. These three players here are from the Team of the Week pack. Not the greatest, let's just say, but that's 30,000 that I didn't have, so I'm grateful for every single coin that I can get in this series. Then Shane Duffy was actually supposed to be an Arsenal investment, my bad, but I was desperate for the coins, so I picked him up for, what was it, 11,000, sold him for 14,500. Then we went through these two centre-backs, Umtiti, I just didn't like him. And it's a problem because he was perfect for the team. Everything worked, and I'll go and show you that in a second. 118,000 we sold him on for. I bought him for 115 on bin. And he just wasn't good enough. Like, he was missing tackles. He didn't feel right. And that's what it comes down to. If he doesn't work for you, or if there are any players on the game that are working for other people and you just can't cut it, then get rid of them. Godin, although he is slower than Umtiti, I felt the quality there. Even when I wasn't like face on with my opponent, and maybe my opponent was doing like some sort of skill or to cut inside on the edge of the box, like, just picture this. I'm standing like at a weird angle, looking away from goal, and then my opponent has like cut inside and he's ready to like finesse it on the edge of the box. If I didn't judge what my opponent was doing and I hit the stand tackle, Godin would like wrap his foot around it and come away with the ball. So I liked that from him. It was a good quality to have, really. Yeah, strong stand tackles, very aggressive, awesome in the air, just a little bit slow, but he was much better than Umtiti. So it didn't really have anything to do with the pace. It's just there was something wrong with that Umtiti card that I just couldn't get on with. And one of the reasons why I sold Godin is because I wanted to bring in more pace. It's just as simple as that. Like, he's a good defender, but I just want to be able to recover a little better. So with, yeah, Godin, we bought him for 70,000, sold him on for 73,500. Skriniar, have you seen the league SBC Serie A? Don't get caught up in the hype though. Like, of course it would be amazing to bring in that special version, and I didn't realize on his base stat he has 92 marking, and I think on that league SBC card it's like 94 with 90 stand tackle. Now don't get me wrong, if they gave him something like 90 overall with some insane stats, I'm not talking about just an inform boost, one of those regular upgrades, I'm on about a big one, like a team and a season, you know, then maybe you could argue 350,000 coins for the card, untradeable, hopefully get some good packs, maybe, but it's just not worth it. They're not giving them the correct boost, and don't, like I say, don't get caught up in the hype, it's not worth it. But Diego Costa we sold on for. Sanchez I sold and I bought him back. He's just that good, man. So I've got Sanchez in the defense, and who else have we got? Inform Lucas Hernandez. I had to repurchase him, man. You'll see the team. But Jorginho, Benzema, Bernardo Silva, these guys here. You want to go and have a look through at some of the Serie A non-informs, silvers, bronzes, in fact, because there are people out there that want to do the league SBC, so you might be able to cash out for some nice profit. But let's take a look at this team, and then I want to go through the club and see what I can actually sell on. Otherwise, we've got an issue. We cannot afford to finish the squad. Let's have a look. So there he is, the red weekly Suarez. What are the chances that we packed the best player from their team of the week? And EA must have heard me when I said, I'm looking for that Dele Alli type player, because last week we discovered someone that worked for us that wasn't that typical Cam. And it was Dele Alli. So I tried Suarez in that position, and some games he came alive, but for the most part, it didn't feel right. And I don't know what was going on. Is he really a Cam? No, Dele Alli is. So I played Suarez as the striker, so I had Mertens overlapping and getting involved, and it's been working a lot better. And I tell you this, Suarez's finishing is breathtaking. The angles that you can score from, stupid. It just doesn't look realistic. And I like that. 95 finishing, the attack positioning, the shot power, the long shots. Has he got a better shot than Dele Alli? Of course he has. And the strength as well. Do you know what? I haven't really noticed too much of the strength and aggression stats. But like I said at the start of the video, Division Rivals has felt a bit weird. I've only had two games that were playable, and that's where Suarez was just turning up, man. So I'm really looking forward to the weekend league to see what this guy can do for the full 40 games. But what a pull. Red Suarez on the account. And as you can see, we've got some chemistry problems, though. We have Hazard off chemistry, Suarez off chemistry, and Sanchez off chemistry. But these are the players that I just wanted to use, right? So I brought back Lucas Hernandez for 143,000 coins. I was just going through the La Liga centre-backs. You had Godin, Umtiti. Now we've moved over to Hernandez again. I just haven't really felt like properly comfortable, and it's not a good feeling going into the weekend league. So 143,000 coins for Hernandez. Sanchez, I had to purchase him back. Adan in goal, he's not terrible, but I'm looking to get Lloris, but then that still doesn't help the fact that we have three players off chem. So instead of Sanchez, it would be Hernandez. But in the left back position, I have purchased Jordi Alba, 68,000 coins, and his stats are actually really good. He can make a tackle, he's got good interceptions, he feels comfortable on the ball, no issues at all, and awesome stamina as well. Valencia, we bought, I don't know if you saw that in the last episode, 20,250, already played 14 games with him. Is he as good as Lala? I don't think so. I really don't. And Lala is a little bit more expensive, but spending the extra 10,000 coins on a very good right back, I think is worth it. Valencia, he's all right, you know. Nothing special about the card. He's making tackles. He doesn't feel great going forward. He's not exactly rapid. It's Valencia. It's okay. He does work, and I need him for just a little bit of chem, right? We could even bring in Trippier, but nah, I ain't doing that. Trippier is a little bit too slow. Maybe as like a centre mid, but not as a fullback. So I just want to show you some of the stats that I have got with Suarez. 14 games, 14 goals, 3 assists. How's Hazard doing? He's gone under a game a goal. Well, it's okay. Suarez is the man leading the attack right now. Mertens is going to be receiving an in-form card. And trust me, I'm going to be doing everything in my power to get that in-form Mertens. I don't care if it's like one or two stat differences. I'm bringing him on the account. I'm going to make as many coins as I can during the week. And hopefully, with those investments, the Arsenal ones, I can sell into the hype and be able to afford someone like a Mertens. But Suso, I brought on right, and he didn't really do too much, but his stat are insane. Another very good player that we pulled from the weekly rewards, like the shot power, the long shots, all of that good stuff. But I want to go through the club and see what we can realistically sell right now that will allow us to bring in someone like Lloris, and then we're going to some live games. I don't think I'm going to start the weekly just yet. I want to get good with the team, man. I'm not playing very well, and it's more to do with like adjusting the tactics and stuff. It has felt very weird. I just want to see how many rares we actually have at the club that we could sell right now. So with Jordi Alba, he's obviously in our starting 11. Socrates, all the Arsenal players ignore. Asensio, yes, we can get rid of him. Depay, I actually use as a super sub. Same with Promes. Kagawa, he's an investment. So it's Mandanda. We have Vass that I don't mind selling. Parolo, Talisca. How many pages of rares? Just to really clear the club, even if we get 700 coins, what I should have done is when they released those Champions League SBCs, is get rid of them then. But I wasn't to know that I was going to be in a position like this where I was desperate for some coins. I've been grinding out Foot Division Rivals as well. We're in Rank 1 currently. And if I can finish overall in Rank 1 after having played the Weekend League, it's looking good. 70,000 coins. But the actual packs the rewards are awful. So I'm kind of forced right now in the division that I'm in to take the coins and to grind out for rank one. But we actually have quite a few pages of rares right now. So what I'll do... Oh, damn. I thought we were going to have a few more than that, though. I don't think that's going to be enough. How much is Lloris? Is he about 40, 50,000 coins? Is he even, like, good enough for us to go and spend the coins on? I don't know. He's going to be better than Adan, surely. 50,000? All right. Yeah, around about 50k. Might be able to snipe him for, like, 48, 49. I think we will be able to afford him. But is he actually worth it, though? You guys, let me know. So look at this right now. We're in rank 1, division 3. And the options that we have, 4 mega packs, 2 premium electrums or whatever they are, which are terrible, or you can dumb that down and only receive like 2 rare player packs, 1 electrum, which is just pointless, 70,000 coins. So we're kind of forced to finish in a rank 1 and get ourselves the 70k. For rank 2, it doesn't really look any different. Just rare mega packs, prime mix players, they're just terrible. Rank 3 actually has the better rewards. 250k packs untradeable, or 150k that is untradeable with the least amount of effort. So how does EA work that one out? But as, like I say, we are here, I'm just going to play the weekend league games and see how many more points I actually need. What is it? Let's show previous. 28,000. I should be able to do that. I'll focus on grinding this account during the week and all that good stuff. But I want to go and show you any changes to the custom tactics, because it has felt a little different over the past couple of days. So we have made some slight changes, nothing too major. Balanced, we've kept that the same on the defensive style. Width, I brought up by the 1. I found myself way too narrow, and I don't really understand it, because it worked last weekend, and after the patch, I haven't really been that comfortable in the defense. Offensive style, still on balance. My width, I like it quite narrow, so they come short and allow me to hold possession. And players inside the box, I up that by the 1 as well, just to get a little bit more going in the attack. But how am I actually playing it? Oh yeah, I've got the new Movember kit, by the way. So yeah, Suarez is the striker, Mertens as the middle cam. That should work quite well. For like other tactics that I want to maybe get back into the game, I'm thinking the 4-2-3-1, right? Constant pressure, have this so my depth is up, because I don't even have a style like that to get back into it. So that's one thing that I need to set on this account, and actually put the depth up all the way. If that's me getting back into the game, this is what I'd recommend. And the width as well, maybe up that just a tad. And then with having Mertens as the cam, yeah, that seems all good for me. Okay, I'm happy with that. So we've got the, well, ultra defensive is now like basically our ultra attacking. So we've got that set. We've got the 4-2-3-1, and we've also got the 4-2-2. Let's move into some division rival games, test all of this stuff out, and hopefully we feel confident playing the weekend league later tonight on stream. So these aren't easy games with our skill rating going up, but I'm ready. Come on. Oh, that's a good ball. He's going to rip me. Already. Jesus, man. Mertens. Suarez. Good play. Back heel. Oh, Mertens, you cheeky boy. But yeah, it's even lagging again. I'm not really understanding the controls right now. Go, out wide. Yes, through. I think I'm on. Am I inside? Nah, it looked kind of off on. It was off. Mertens, oh, through. Yes, Mertens. What on Suarez, that's a bit more composure. That's a foul. That is a foul. Quickly, quickly, quickly. Play it back to Mertens. But where's the cursor going? Yeah, even the cursor's out of sync right now. Suarez. And that's the game changer. That's the difference in tight games where it may be lagging. You may have delay in the weekend league. This guy is going to change everything. And you know what's really nice with Suarez? Is that he has the 4-star weak foot over Dele Alli. So if I'm cutting to the left or the right, with his high finishing anyway, it feels like a 5-star weak foot. No. Oh, good finish. That's a good play. Hazard. Oh, the composure. I think I did him. 3-2 full time in a laggy ass game. We did grind it out though. We scored some nice goals. What I'm having problems with though is just Suarez's pace on counterattacks. I want to be able to get through a little bit better, and I think he's holding me back, but if I play him as a cam, it's not really working, so I'm just unsure as to which position I want to play him in right now. So here we go, 5-bar connection it says. I don't know if I believe that. Wow, that was quick. Heavy touch from Fred. Through ball though, Hazard. Go on, Hazard. It's getting away from players as well. Go. Through. Mertens. That's got to go in. Right. Maybe getting down the line a little bit more. Out wide. Yes, yeah, Suarez. Now, Suarez does provide a bit of vision. Good passing and stuff. What a ball back post. Oh, that's probably the best save that I've seen so far. Leno just sat on the ball. At least in this game, I can actually play a switch when I want to. It's really helping me out. Go. Ooh, that could be a red card. It was from behind. Suarez. Good run. See, a little bit more pace in that position. Maybe I'll be able to be a bit more effective. Lucas. I want to get Suarez involved. The positioning from Suarez. Is he onside? No question. The attack positioning. He was in acres of space. I haven't been too impressed, though, with Fred after the patch. Valencia's been okay. Who else I'm not liking the feel of? No, just really Fred and Alan, to be fair. Alan and Fred, just my CDMs haven't been commanding enough for my liking. Mertens, beautiful. Good reactions. Lovely pass. Flick that in front of you. Give it back to him. Where's Suarez? That's got to be a foul, surely. Oh, that ball, though. Well done. Sanchez. There are so many rebounds going on. Could be the fact that he's on 6 chem. I'm just putting it out there. Oh, yes, that touch. Through ball. Let's go. Good save, Leno. So nothing really happened in that second half. Wasn't able to build on the goals that we scored in the first. And it's build-up play and holding possession, which is what I don't have right now. So can you think of any last minute changes we could possibly make to get a few more players on chem? Maybe even selling like Lucas Hernandez and reworking the left hand side. I don't know. Like before I go and rush out and sell some of those rares that we've got at the club and purchase a Hugo Lloris, if you do have any ideas, make sure to hit me up on Twitter. I will be live later tonight streaming the RTG, playing some weekend league games. But is Suarez really the guy that we're looking for? Because when he's inside the box, you don't even need to do a time finish. It's going to fly in the back of the net. Outside the box, if you hit those times from stupid angles, they're going to go in. So is he really doing enough? Like when I'm trying to catch my opponents on counters, he doesn't have that pace or the dribbling to really hold possession properly or how I would play. So yeah, we got to like weigh up the options right now. Do we use Suarez that's just going to find the back of the net? Is it really to do with me not controlling the game as much and then allowing him to drift into positions? Because the way I'm playing right now, the way my team is setting out, is to go on counters, and Suarez, he doesn't seem to be that counter-attacking player. So what I've got to do is hold possession, build up properly, and be able to pass. And that's probably why I haven't really got the best out of him right now. But saying that, 16 games, 16 goals, 3 assists, he knows where the back of the net is. So I want to use him for this weekend and see if I can play properly. So we'll keep him as the striker. And then in the attack, yeah, Mertens as the middle cam. I'm just not happy with maybe Lucas Hernandez, the goalkeeper, having really Sanchez off chem for the second weekend in a row. And Valencia is kind of average. He's not bad. I just preferred Lala. So that's where I'm at right now with the team. I need some suggestions right now. It could even be like we get rid of Hernandez, Adan. I don't want to get rid of Jordi Alba, and I need the chem link into Suarez anyway. It's just annoying. It's so difficult to link Suarez into the team. And because we brought him in, it means Hazard's off chem as well. Or what we could do is like change the right hand side a little bit and have like DeMarcos in form, then he can link into like Suarez. I know it's only a weak link, but that could be an option. It's annoying, man. And that's where I'm at right now in the team. As you can tell, we've got some chem problems. we aren't really playing that well, but we're grinding out results. So hopefully we can carry that through to the weekend league. But thank you very much for watching. Like I always say, if you've got any ideas and you want to help me out, head over to Twitter at Fuji720PYT is my Twitter handle. Thank you very much for watching. Leave a like and I will see you on the next one. Team out. Peace.